Hi everyone, this is Nick, and I wanted to jump on and do kind of a make this slide step-by-step sort of tutorial for something that I saw on LinkedIn over at the St. Louis Zoo's LinkedIn page. They made a Happy Pride post, and I loved this sort of graphic that they created with the rainbow colors with animals inside those squares. Really, really cool. And I thought, well, let's see if we can make this in PowerPoint. I think that we probably can. So let's go over to my PowerPoint slide, and this is kind of a version of that. What we're going to do in this tutorial is I'm going to show you how to insert shapes onto your PowerPoint slide, and then how to fill those shapes appropriately, the right way, with photos that we've downloaded. So I went over to PowerPoints in their stock photos. So just go to the Insert tab and then click on Stock Images. From there, you can search anything, and they will pop up with hundreds and hundreds of free photos that you can use that are very high quality as well. So I have these here just to show you that I've downloaded each of them, but what I'm going to do is make sure that they're a large size. If we want this to fill the rectangles that we're going to create for this slide, we need to make sure that the photos are nice and big that we're putting in there. So I'm actually just going to hold down Shift key, highlight all of them, and I'm just going to go ahead and just drag them out like that so that they're nice and big. All right, so now we go and we want to insert our rectangles. So this is just a rectangle shape that you get right from PowerPoint, and you just go to the Insert tab, click on Shapes, and then you can select Rectangle. And then from there, you can go ahead and drag your PowerPoint shapes all the way over however you like to organize them on your slide there. But I've already inserted all of mine, and I've colored them to that kind of Roy G. Biv rainbow sort of coloration right there. And remember, to update the colors, all you need to do is click on the shape, go over to the Format Shape menu over here, and click on the little paint bucket. Click on Solid Fill, and then there you can change the colors like this right from the palette, any of those that you see, or you can create your own custom colors from that list as well. All right, let's go ahead and insert some photos. Now I'm going to insert the puffin here in this red rectangle. So I'm going to go back to my photo slide here. I think this is the puffin right here. Yep. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut this. Control X. I'm going to cut that out. It's going to put it onto my clipboard. And here I'm going to highlight my rectangle right here. Go over to that Format Shape menu. Instead of Solid Fill, we're going to say Picture or Text Fill. And what I'm going to say is From Clipboard, because I have the puffin picture on my clipboard. And now you can see that is nice and beautiful. Now, if this picture was stretched in any way, what you need to do is keep that rectangle highlighted. Go to the Picture Format tab. Click on Crop, and then we're going to say Fill. So click on Fill right there, and that will actually allow you to move the photo and fill the shape in a proportional way so that the photo isn't stretched taller or wider in any way. So then you can just go ahead. I like to hold down Shift key and just kind of drag it over to where I want to put it. And I like this option right here. Let's see if that goes. Perfect. And then I'm just going to click outside of that, and now it's nicely cropped. Now, if I want this to be red, now see that my red color went away. I don't have to put another box over this. I can actually click on this box right here, click on the rectangle with the photo in it, go up to the Shape Format tab, and then actually go over to the Picture Format tab, and under Adjust, you can do lots of different color adjustments here to your photos right from these PowerPoint menus here. So under Color, I'm just going to say, let's go to More Variations, and I'm going to go down here to that red. And now you can see that color has sort of been filled with that red color, or that the photo has been filled with the red sort of background. It looks really nice. Now let's see, my next one was a picture of a seal. I think this is the picture of a seal. We'll bring that to the front. Perfect. I'm going to say Control X to cut it out. We'll go back to this orange shape. Again, we're going to click on Picture Fill, and we've already filled it, the first one with the puffin, so that picture is right there, but I'm going to go ahead and say again From Clipboard, and that will put whatever is on my clipboard into that photo. And now the seal looks really nice. Let's just make sure that it's filled again, so make sure to go up to the Crop button and then click on Fill, and then we can go ahead and adjust the position if we want to. Click on Crop. Looks really, really nice. And now let's change that color to the orange. Click the photo again. Picture Format, Color, and I'm going to go to More Variations again here, and I think we'll just do this orange right there. really nice and a really cool photo effect. I think it looks really, you know, it looks very elevated. It looks very interesting. I bet a lot of people won't know that you made this slide or slide like this inside of PowerPoint. You can use this trick to fill any other type of shape with a photo in PowerPoint. And remember that that trick of going up to that crop button and then clicking on fill. That's how you get the photos nice and proportionate in PowerPoint. If you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a fantastic time making this for you today, and I can't wait to see you all next time.